Solo, A Star Wars Story, is the newest Star Wars film, and as I'm sure you all know by now, it is the story of young Han Solo, and the film chronicles how he got into the smuggling business, how he met Chewbacca, how he met Lando Calrissian. It's basically the Han Solo genesis that everybody has been positively anticipating. And before I get into what I think about this film, there's my ticket, there's my proof. I have actually seen this film, so I can actually give an opinion on this film. Just wanted to clarify that for some of the idiots out there. Alright, so the build-up to this film, for a lot of people, has been, I'm not looking forward to this, I never asked for this, boo boo, it's not Harrison Ford. I feel like I'm one of the few people who is actually looking forward to this film because, unlike a lot of people, I did not grow up watching the original trilogy, so I don't have an attachment to the character of Han Solo and Harrison Ford as Han Solo. So I was completely open to seeing a new actor play Han Solo, and I was actually excited to see a young Han Solo because I do kind of like prequel stuff when it's done right. And now that I've seen Solo, I can tell you guys that I actually enjoyed it. Is it a perfect film? Is it a flawless film? No, it is not. It has problems, it has flaws, which I'll get to in a little bit. But for now, let's talk about some good stuff. First off, Alden Ehrenreich was really good as Han Solo, not doing a Harrison Ford impression. He's making the character his own, but still making it feel like Han Solo. And the way he was speaking, his mannerisms, and even the way he was walking, I was like, that is Han Solo. I was really impressed with how he managed to bring everything to the character, but still made it his own and not a Harrison Ford impression. He did a really good job. And Donald Glover as Lando Calrissian was really smooth, really charming, but he wasn't in the film as much as I thought it would be. Just given all the hype around Donald Glover as Lando, I was expecting him to be in the film more than he actually was. I love the chemistry between Han Solo and Chewbacca. Even though it's not Harrison Ford and it's not Peter Mayhew, it still feels like classic Han and Chewie back and forth. And Chewbacca in this film is actually quite a badass. There are scenes where he just starts beating the piss out of people, throwing them into ceilings, smashing them on the floor, and I was like, Chewbacca's awesome. All the other actors did good jobs in their roles as well. Woody Harrelson as Beckett was good. Emilia Clarke as Kira was good. I like Phoebe Waller-Bridge as Lando's droid. I can't remember the droid's name, I'm sorry. And for me personally, it was really cool seeing the genesis of everything Han Solo, seeing how he met Chewbacca and how he met Lando, and when he first sees the Millennium Falcon, and the first time Han Solo and Chewbacca sit side by side in the Falcon and it plays that Star Wars theme, it put a big grin on my face. Even though I'm not a diehard Star Wars fan, I'm not attached to these characters and this lore, it still put a smile on my face because of all the adventures they're going to have in this spaceship from here on out. Getting into the film itself, the first two thirds I really enjoyed. It was a really fun space adventure, really cool space western kind of heist film, and it had some really great action sequences, like the train scene that you've seen in the trailer was probably the best action sequence in the entire film. It was really cool. And I really enjoyed seeing more of the criminal underworld of Star Wars. That is something that I've always wanted to see in a film, and that's one of the things I wanted the most out of Solo. And we see certain things, we hear about gangsters and different crime syndicates, and I was just eating all this up because it's something I've wanted to see ever since Return of the Jedi, seeing all those bounty hunters in Jabba's palace. And plus, coming off of The Last Jedi, which is a very complex and very heavy film, it was really nice to have Solo, which was just a good old space adventure, really, really simple, not a very demanding story to get invested into, but it was a really fun space adventure that I enjoyed watching. And the film doesn't show scars of reshoots either, which was one of my fears going into it, because Ron Howard completely refilmed it after Lord and Miller got booted off it. I was worried that it was going to be really choppy and all over the place, but it really wasn't. It was quite a smooth ride. But like I said earlier, the film does have issues, which I will address right now. The first two thirds I really enjoyed, like I said. The third act is where the film kind of stumbled for me. Without spoiling it, there's a couple of twists and turns that happen, and there were things that were really easily telegraphed, like before the film. Like going into the film, I thought to myself, okay, I think this might happen and that might happen, but whilst watching the film, all those theories kind of wash away and I just experience the film. So when these things happen later on, I'm like, oh yeah, there it is. And that's really the problem. Whenever you have a twist or a turn, it should never make you go, oh yeah, there it is. It should really floor you and go, what the hell was that? But none of the twists in Solo did that for me. And plus, the way the film just wrapped up in the third act in general, I found kind of underwhelming, which again, I can't talk about because of spoilers, but just the way just things came to conclusion, the way the film ended and wrapped up, it was kind of abrupt when it cut to the credits. I was like, oh, okay, it's time to go, I suppose. The third act as a whole was kind of underwhelming for me, especially since the first two were so much fun. And the film itself isn't really a deep film. There's not really a lot of weight to it, a lot of emotional weight. They try to have emotional weight sometimes, but it never really lands like it wants to. So if you're looking for a really compelling narrative and really compelling character to get invested in with Solo, you're going to be disappointed. But overall, guys, I honestly had quite a bit of fun with Solo. It was a really fun space adventure with great action sequences, some cool characters. Alden Ehrenreich was really good as Han Solo. In fact, I'm actually open to seeing Alden Ehrenreich play Han Solo again. It's not without its flaws for sure. It's not the best Star Wars film, but it is not the worst Star Wars film. I've already seen some snarky dicks in the comment section say things like, well, the prequels don't look too bad now, do they? No. It might not be a great film, it might not be the best Star Wars film, but it is still a thousand times better than those whiny, crybaby Anakin Skywalker, Mesa, Jar Jar Binks pieces of crap that the prequels were. It's a fun space adventure that is a bit predictable and not the most remarkable or compelling film, but I still had a lot of fun watching Solo for the most part, so overall, I'm going to give Solo a Star Wars Story a 3.5 out of 5. So Solo a Star Wars Story, have you guys seen it? What did you think about it? And do you want to see more of Alden Ehrenreich as Han Solo? Do you want to see further adventures of Han Solo? Or are you just one of the people who could not care less? Whatever your thoughts are, let me know down there. And if you want to see more of my stuff, click on one of these and I'll see you all in the next video.